Bonjour Etudyan. So I welcome you again for this video. In this video we are going to see about the last 10th and 11th exercise of lesson 1. Okay. So before going to the exercise, we will discuss about what are the things we know about the expressions, okay, the cause of expressions and the negation and the restrictions. All this will be discussed, then we'll follow the exercise. Let us go into the video. Okay. Bonjour Etudyan. So in this video we will be looking into the lesson number 1, the last 10th exercise and 11th exercise together. Okay. So before getting into the exercise, I would like to discuss you with the certain points. So here we have the expressions de la cause, means we have the expressions of the cause. So here you have three words. One is parsaka, piusca, or como. So these words will be used. And the meaning of parsaka is because, then piusca is since, and como is as. So these French conjunctions are commonly used to draw conclusions or otherwise relate a cause or explanation with the result or conclusion. These conjunctions have similar but not identical meaning and uses. Okay, they are very similar, but they have identical but not identical meaning and uses, that you have to understand. Okay, so first we will see about parsaka. Because parsaka introduces a cause, explanation or motive. It basically explains why something is done. Parsaka introduces a cause or a reason unknown to the person. Okay, parsaka usually introduces the second part of the sentence. It is also less formal and more universal, accepted as the English equivalent for the word because. Okay, so that is the usage of parsaka. Next one is piusca. Piusca is a subordinating conjunction. Okay, parsaka introduces a cause, explanation or motive or a reason to an unknown person. But here piusca is a subordinating conjunction and can begin a sentence always. And piusca gives an obvious explanation or justification rather than a cause. Okay. Piusca implies that the fact is already known or very obvious. So that is known. But parsaka is unknown. Okay. So that is the difference you should have. Then next one, last, como, is like used in the beginning of a sentence. Same thing like piusca. Highlights the link between the consequence and its result. Here it is a logical cause known by all. So here also it is known. The only thing, parsaka is only, the fact is unknown, but for piusca and comma it is already known. Okay, here you have certain examples. Why the student is he absent? He is absent because he is sick. Okay, since he is sick, he is absent. Like he is sick, he has not gone to the school today. Then why the roads are they slippery? Okay, why the roads are they slippery? Because it rains without stopping, the roads are slippery. Like it rains non-stop, the roads are slippery. The roads are slippery because it rains without non-stop. Okay, so these are the things you have to understand in this particular concept. Okay. Yeah, next you have the restriction, that is siulma means only. Okay, they have returned only the night. They have only transformed for, or they have changed, they have only changed the place. So this is one, they use siulmo for only. Okay, so this is the concept, but it is not given in your exercise. Next we have the negation, that is normally we have done negative with ne pa, but here you do it with ne akun. So here it is just used as the same thing, but ne akun is always followed by singular in French. So note that AUCUN or AUCUNE agree in gender with the object it refers to. So whenever you write, see whether the object is in masculine form or feminine form. If it is masculine, the spelling will be AUCUN. If it is feminine, it will be AUCUNE. Okay, so that is the thing you have to remember. It accepts only with the gender. Okay, masculine or feminine, it doesn't go with the number. Either it is singular or plural, doesn't matter. But in gender, you have to see. Okay, it refers to, but never agrees in number as they describe an absence of things, because here when you use nekun means nothing, so in that we don't require any number. Okay, they are always singular. You can use nekun as you use nepa to negate a sentence, same like nepa. Wherever you replace, how do you replace nepa? Before and after the verb, same thing like that. Okay, the construction of this is ne akun or a-u-c-u-n-e, that is a feminine form, means none or not more or not one or not any or no. So this one is only, you have to remember, just ne, same like nepa, you have to understand. Okay, so il ashate kalka kadu means he has bought some gift. So il ne ashate, so here what happens is the only difference is nepa can be written before and after the word, but this alone it can be written after the past participle. So that is the difference you have. Okay, il ne a ashate, then you see that a-u-c-u-n. Here they are only buying the, so only gift, only one, so singular. There is no number present, only masculine or feminine. So kadu is masculine, so it a-u-c-u-n is left. So il ne ashate akun kadu means he has not bought any gift. Then she il that is il adala aspire means she has some hope of it. So no il ne akun aspire, so he has no hope or nothing like that. Il a the difficulty, so now you can see difficulty is a feminine, so they have used the feminine form of it. So il ne akun difficulty, he has no difficulties. Then il a the infant, so infant is masculine, so they have changed to masculine form. No il ne a akumpa, so here only the thing, if it is written in passé composé like that, wherever past participle comes in a sentence, it can be written after the past participle, but nepa is not written after the past participle, before the past participle you write. Okay, so now after this we'll go into the exercise. So this is the 10th exercise you have associated. So we are going to use all we are going to associate these two sentences with the expression of cause. Okay, so we'll go into the, so here they have given the questions. Il ne a pa envoyé means I have not sent the mail, so you have to say, tell a reason. Then il ne vient pas, he has not come. The next one, tu arrives retard, you arrive late, you arrived late. Then il ne pa allé au mariage means she has not gone to the marriage. Then il a brûlé la feu, so he has jumped or he has passed through the signal. So now let us see how it is arranged. Now this is the answer. Il ne pa envoyé la mail means because parsaka je ne pa eu the connection the internet, so because I didn't have any internet connection. Next one, il ne vient pas, he has not come, like he has been an impeachment means he has had something else happen to him. Okay, next one, il arrive en retard, so you are or you arrived late, so they used parsaka because il avait de embotilés, because there was a traffic jam. Next one, il n'est pas allé au mariage, she has not gone to the marriage because parsaka illa fatigue, because she was tired. Next one, illa brûlé de feu means he has jumped, like he is in hurry. So this all the expressions the expressions are used according to the requirement. Already we have discussed what is it. Okay, now we'll go to the 11th exercise, the last exercise of the lesson 1. So here they have used the negation, so I told you nakun access only with the gender, not with the number. Okay, so we have to see what object you are going to replace, and according to that you have to give. Okay, if it is masculine you write a u c u n, if it is feminine a u c u n e. Okay, and one more thing, nepa can be written before and after the verb, but here nakun can be written after the past participle also, in like passé composé tense, in plusque parfait, like that. Okay, so now we'll go to the exercise. Was away on problem. So now here itself, from the question itself, you can understand it is masculine. Yun problem. So on problem is masculine. So whenever you replace, you can say a u c u n. No, ne omo akun problem. So no, I don't have any problem. We don't have any problem. Next one, il the ami. So here they are replying. So that also you have to be very careful. So whenever the question is in second person, the question goes to the first person, either it is singular or plural. So the first one, who's away, the question is in second person plural, so your answer is first person plural, quite obvious. No ne ava akun problem, so no, we do not have any problem. The next one, illa da ami, she has some friends. So here you have to see the spelling of the friends, A-M-I-E-S. So it is feminine plural, but feminine is accepted, right? No ilneyakum ami. So she has no friend. The next one, tu avu kelka film. So you have seen few films. No janai vu. So here you can see it is written after the past participle, janai vu, then a-u-c-u-n. Okay, so this is what I mentioned. But nepa cannot be written like this. It should be written before and after the verb. Then only the past participle comes. But here, after the past participle, you write a-u-c-u-n. Okay, janai vu un film. So I have not seen any film. Then il konai the actor français. So il konai the actor français. So he knows some French actors. No, il ne connaît aucun acteur français. He doesn't know any French actors because, and in this it is written in third person singular, the answer also can remain in third person. Then vous lisez the roman français. You read some French novels. No, nous ne lisons aucun roman français. No, we don't read any French novels. So Nayakun accepts only with the gender, not with the number. So you have to be very careful in that. Okay. So this is, we have finished entire first lesson. I hope so you have understood all the exercise. I want you to copy down everything in your classwork. See you children. Bye.